bicambrial, two-house federal system that we have in Washington is a lot like the, a lot like what we have here in Virginia. They based elements of how that works. They based it on the Virginia example. But there are significant differences. So, and pardon me for being the only one talking, Court. I think what we decide is I'll sort of work on this, and then as we get into more specific issues, it'll be less a monologue on my part, and I hope everyone forgives me for that. I do like to hear myself talk, but at the same time, I am aware that other people should be able to talk to.
I'll jump in when I have something to say.
Exactly. Here's the thing. So the Virginia General Assembly has two houses, okay? There is the House of Delegates and the Senate of Virginia, right?
Right.
So they are similar to what we have in Washington. The House of Delegates has more members. There are 100 members in the House of Delegates. They represent 100 districts in the state. I think an average district is...
But it is neither blue nor red. It is getting bluer. all the time. And it's also getting more progressive. I don't know about you guys, but we're not politically oriented, or oriented organization. You know, candidates, obviously haven't in the past, somebody we might, but we haven't yet. And we are not Democrats. We have a lot of friends in the party, and they are certainly a lot closer as a group, and certainly individual members and stuff, to the progressive values and issues that we are very interested in. But we do not, we are not an arm of the Democratic Party. We are not involved with campaigns and things like that. I don't believe that much. So with that in mind, yes, what we really want more is progressive. We don't spend a lot of time bashing, Democrats who don't follow all of our wishes. But we also, we are not simply looking to be, as we have behind people today. We want real progressive change, and because of the way the DNA has been now for a decade or more, a decade and a half, we didn't have a drive for that. There are a lot of things that we have been able to do. And we'll explain in a little while, some of the things that we'd like to see from this session. But, it is still an uphill battle, even after this landslide election. So, 100 members in the House of Delegates, 40 members in the Senate. It's only bicameral, legislature. Cameral is what? That looks like a geological. Although there are fossils, there are a number of fossils at the General Assembly. Although we were there were back in October, we put it that way. So, what that means is that legislation that is introduced in one house has to pass through that house, but then move to the other house. So, a house bill, that goes in the House of Delegates, has to pass the House of Delegates, then it has to go over and go through the same process in the Senate and pass there, and then it would go to the governor to decide or veto. That process is, and by the way, same thing. So you have a bill in the Senate, they pass the Senate, and then they walk over to the House, and they do the same process. So what happens when a bill is introduced, and we can talk a little about this, what's been going on. There are a lot of different ways to come up. When you talk to legislators, over the course of the, when I say weeks, we would probably have at least one or two legislators in here to talk, and I'm fairly comfortable with what that does. And where do bills come from? Bills come from constituents, right? You can have a bill that says, I want to stop this thing that's happening, or I want more of this thing happening. Let's say, I'm going to give you a classic example, which is the bills that don't really mean anything, but we still see a lot of them. Let's say I would like to have a license plate that honors the memory of a fallen soldier, or seven soldiers, or something like that, right? So I would go to my representative, my delegate, or my senator, or both, and I would say, I want this done, right? And they would say, I think that's a good idea. Let's do it. And they would write that bill up and put it in, and it's to get a bill number, so it's doing something called legislative information services, to look at it and write it up so that it's accurate and correct. And then it goes to get the bill number, and it goes to the House, and let's go through that process. The next thing that might happen would be, let's say I am a bank, right? I have a powerful banking interest, and I also would like some legislation passed, but this would not be, let's say, a license, right? I would instead like banking regulations in Virginia to be less restrictive in the sense of the language they would use, right? So, I would call a tax special lobbying firm, and they would also go to members of the General Assembly, Senators, or the House, and they would say, here's a bill of the that will make a lot of money for us, and but the same process would happen, right? It still goes through legislative representation. It still goes to, it still gets a gold number, but still goes in the hopper, and see, right? So, where delegates get ideas to go, they get them from constituents, or the members they come from. I saw a story in the news about the Senator Mark, who's retired, but the Senator Mark. Senator Mark, a couple of years ago, some people like to keep them, right? The celebratory act, right? And when you see it done up in the air, the bullet eventually comes down. And in this case, someone has fired a gun out of the air and came out of the shower for Senator Marsh saw that in the news, and he didn't need to tell us, or the audience to tell us, that something would be really do something about that. It's not like you can stop it altogether. But he did have a big broad of legislation that he didn't have passed that made it more that raised the penalty for that kind of behavior. So sometimes it comes just kind of out of their own hands. So you've got, something in the news, you see things like that, how would that be effective? I saw this in the paper. Sometimes, and I think you've seen this at the national level with the current administration, that it depends what kind of news they want, that sometimes they come in with ideas that are not always accurate or, exactly. So you'll see bills like that. And so now you've got this situation, right? So I've got a bill, and it goes through the number. And what happens to that bill after it gets that number? So, on the House side, the Speaker of the House assigns bills to the job. That would be Mr. Fox himself, yes, it is Kirkland. That's where I was thinking, and pretty good question. He's our new speaker. Bill Howard, the founder of the not a lot of guests, but it sounds like it's good. So the Speaker of the House, on the House side, sends bills to various committees that he thinks should take them up. For instance, a bill that would, send them on to the let's say there's a House bill for that. That bill would probably go to the courts, if we can go, for instance, to health and welfare, we can go to the education committee. Those are meant to go where the committees that deal with that department although it actually can make this too. Because sometimes some committees are where you want to go to go, and some committees are not where you want to go. So what he got is he decides, he said that on the Senate side, in fact, he's working on the Senate side where it goes. The bill goes to the what's fascinating, I think, about the thing that is it your first year really with the general sense, right?
Yeah.
It's kaleidoscopic how quickly things move, right? So yeah, I mean, they've got to do all this business and then do it, right? And remember I said before that I kind of have to bounce and then go to the Senate and vice versa. So, well, it's a 60-day session and we have to go for a long session or a short session. Long session 60 days, short session 45. This year we have a long session, so long session is close to the biennial budget in Virginia. So the long session is going to go on the budget. Short session is back in the last 60 days, you only got 30 days to get the bill out of the committee. I mean, out of your own house, right? So I put a bill in the house. I have basically 60 days to have that bill passed, which, because in the middle of the general assembly, I have to go across. What crossover is both of the two houses, the Senate and the House, have to finish what they're doing, right? All they have to pass, all the legislation that won't pass, and send it over to the other house. But if it doesn't get done by then, the bill is history, right? What happens, you know, at that end this year, I think it's usually around that. All that business has to get done in case that got the money that ran out of speed. Traditionally, although the countries that I've worked in before, traditionally we work for business. And there are 11 or 13 states. I think I don't know. I think it's 11 on the Senate and 13 on the House side. I don't think it's going to be that much information, but those committees meet once or twice a week, and each of those committees have subcommittees, right? That there's a business around that goes for subcommittees first, they have to move from subcommittee up to the hearing floor, then they go to the committee, then they go to the floor, they can pass out. But I mean, basically, for instance, between now and crossover, some of the committees will like it. That will definitely be so that is eight chances at getting a hearing. And you will see in the big committees, they will be really appreciated. You know? So a lot of bills that aren't controversial move like, you know, what's going to go up, but they might be doing their term, right? I can see it like, yeah, that sounds like a good idea. Somebody else agree? Boom. Well, I think you. I don't have the language skills that the president does. I'll leave it to your imagination. But yeah, so it is remarkable how quick it goes and how fast things can progress. So the building committee is smaller. Large committees on the outside have 22 members in each committee. Members all sit on different committees, so you might have, you know, 3 or 4 committees that move a lot of your day and you have different committees. You are moving so much more, 2,000 bills a year will be executed, which is incredible when you think of it. Basically, you deal with those bills. I came to EPA from Congress, I worked out in the lobbyist in Congress, and I will be sitting in Congress for a month, more than usually, experience. You could have a bill, Congresses are close. There he is,
hi Charlie.
Hi Charlie.
Good to see you. We are on the air. On the air, we are joined by a friend and colleague, Charlie Schmidt from the APV.
Yeah, hello, thank you. Sorry I'm late.
Not a problem.
driving crap out here.
It's a great thing, driving at night, speed down, and up less.
Plus, I would like to vote, and all of that. As we are learning on the fly.
It sounded great. I was riding in, even with the weather, I can hear it coming up in my car. It was great.
We are so excited and grateful to have this opportunity to work on school. I was telling them today, and then afterwards, we were looking to probably try to keep this but I'm really glad to have you guys here. So I'm going to wrap up my little civics lesson.
I heard Cameron Fossil.
Yes, by Cameron. I prefer to by Cambriel.
Cambriel, that's the one.
By Cambriel.
Sorry to bring up fun every
day. I wonder if now that I'm thinking about it, I don't use Cambriel that often. We work with a thing called the community, and those are the things, and that's where we get to work. And this, by the way, is where it's coming from, and we're pushing a path for you guys when you see that there's a bill in the general assembly that you like, don't like, one of the places where you can get involved. Because a bill that not passed is heavy, it is highly unlikely that that bill will be taken up by the House, other House of Representatives. It is half of the bill. That's a good chance, and to at least make public testimony. Committees also know a few people on committees, so you want to contact people. That is the place where you can be focused on activism, trying to get people to support the movement. Part of it is just looking. They are working with someone. I will tell you that when committees are run by people who don't like, heads up about kind of going like we heard in the previous time. If they are less inclined, then they can say, I don't know, and I don't know.
And so, for the listeners out there, I have a question. Who makes that decision?
Committee chair. Committee chairs in the committee are fairly powerful. They are not as powerful as they are in the committee, but they are still fairly powerful. And committee chair decides when it's going to be heard, and only decides, and there's that problem with this, because it's more of an official than official. We certainly have bills that this is going to be done, and a committee chair will be doing this, and that bill will never be done. And I'm supposed to do that, but that's everything. They have a lot of people who have a special problem. One of the things they should just federal government, less than our
smoking area.
bunch of people in January, February, smoking those cigarettes and getting by, you know, so it was, I would miss it.
Sorry, I digress.
No.
You had to take us off track.
That kind of brutalist, that sort of 70s brutalist architecture, I mean, one of the reasons that
Well, I mean, I will say that despite the building, despite how it's not adequate, despite the session being short and being cold early in the morning, I did talk to some of the coaches and 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 some of the
Yeah.
And that is something that everyone should be proud of, really. And so, like I said, for those who want to go down here now, the building is much nicer. Definitely, it's like south of the Capitol Square. And so far, it's been very welcoming.
I just said this randomly, this is people, this is all.
No, you're right.
I know our organization has a team that we're specifically working on. But also, I know you guys, I've talked to somebody about this, you guys are not sure. There's always more. And then I thought, trying to go for codes to make sure that you've got the money in place. There's always a lot of stuff happening. So what I'm looking at are basically the issues that I have written down that I think will probably come up. A lot of them are things that have happened before, but again, we have a somewhat different presentation this year than we've had in the past. So, while Republicans want to move people from houses to the VA, they're just going with by, difference in both houses. So, while the general subject has been a Republican caucus on the 2020 as a result of these elections, because basically, the draft law of the president of the low-hanging fruit is sort of not the best passage for a matter than the Republican politics. And so they are in the Republican or the conservative and the rural caucus, but there are people of them. And in the Republican legislature, they are the rules.
Yeah.
They are aware of what happened.
As I said earlier, all three of our organizations deal with policy and principles of welcome to both sides, not politics, but principles.
Exactly.
And it's easy. I mean, we have worked with folks on both sides of town, but as you said, principles and policies are not more of a Democrat. But there are a lot of issues that people need to understand that.
Thank you.